checking my snares. You should, if you didn't watch it, go watch it. I got a rabbit in my snare, so I'm gonna be showing you how to get it. So first of all, you wanna have a knife, and you don't need scissors, but I suggest you take scissors. So at the first start, chop the feet off, the legs off, and the head off, so then you could easily cut it. So you take this piece of skin like this, and you take the scissors or a knife. I use scissors so I don't get cut, and you just cut it. And then you take your hands and you stick your two thumbs or fingers underneath the skin and just keep doing that. And if you're wondering why I'm not just ripping it, it's because it's frozen and it's hard, and also because I'm gonna tan it. If you do, you don't want to cut it, so then there's not holes in your thing. And the reason why this is taking long is because it's frozen and because I want to tan it. There we go, I'm finally getting under the skin now. The first part is harder than the middle. It's just the first part, it's because it's stuck. The skin, after you get to about, see where my thumb is, like right past the legs right there, then it's starting to get easy. Because I could just stick my thumb under it and cut it. See, you just stick this under and cut it. So after that, you just keep sticking your thumb in as far as you can reach. And that's how you skin it. But if you don't want to tan it, you could just take a cut and just rip it off. That's what I did with my first few rabbits. I took it and I just ripped it off the skin, but I started wanting to tan it, so now I do it slowly. So I'm gonna do a cut to when I'm done skinning it. So see you when we're done skinning it. So after you are done, it should look something like this on the outside and on the inside like this. And don't worry about all the blood on the other side, because when you tan it and clean it, it'll just come right off, all the stains. So what I do is, because you see here how the feet, when you pull it off the legs, it's like that. I just take scissors and I go and I cut it right up there. Open it up so it's not like things like that. See, like that, it's opened up. So I find the other leg right here. And you stick it right up the leg. And you just cut. These scissors are kind of bad, that's why it's taking a second. What you want to do is take a knife, a sharp one, so it can cut through the skin. You want to grab the rabbit skin right here, you want to pinch it right around here. You want to take a knife, you want to just cut softly so you don't cut the pea sack, because if you cut the pea sack, it ruins the meat. So after a little cut, I take scissors, and I could get my finger in there. I take scissors, and I just stick them in there, and I try not to cut the guts, so all the guts don't get on the meat, because and it ruins it, like I said. Stick it in, lift up as far as you can, and then cut. So you're not on the desk. And then you gotta do that for the chest. I'm gonna turn the rabbit around so it's easier for me because I'm on the other side of it. You cut right up the chest, all the way to the heart and the liver. Because you might forget about it, and then you'll put it in the freezer or wherever you put it. The heart and the liver will still be there. So you cut right up to there, and you just spread it open like that, and there's the heart and the liver and all this stuff. So I'm gonna do a cut after to where I'm done cutting it, because some people might not want to watch me gut it, so I'm gonna do a cut to where I'm done gutting it, and then I'll show you what it looks like after that. So I told you that I wasn't gonna show you, I'm not, but when you do gut it, you take your fingers and you stick it right up to here, and you just pull down, and all the guts fall out. It might be hard, but harder, but just pull hard, and they will all come out. So that's what you do, and I'm not gonna show you how to gut it. I'm not gonna show you me gutting it, because it's bloody, you might not like it. So after you're done cleaning them off and done gutting it, it should look something like this. You push these legs down and you cut it right here. So after you do that, it should look something like this inside. And you see this meat? You just take it and you grab it or cut it. I just grab it off because it's really fatty. You can leave it on if you want, but I don't. People use this for sandwiches. They fry it up and eat it, but I just cut it off and throw it out because it's kind of fatty. I'm gonna put that on the other side. Just cut it all the way there and cut it off. It's okay if you break his ribs or something, that's fine. That's pretty much it. That's how I got and skinned my rabbits. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed.